Such masks are generally worn when dealing with toxic chemicals. It appears as though the protective equipment is missing from here. Gloves, waterproof aprons, everything one might need for self-protection.
Do they grow dangerous plants here?
Locked.
Holmes, Albert Dunn didn't give us the key to this door.
It does not matter. We will open it. Open. Martin Hamish's locker. A review on rare and exotic plants. Martin Hamish has written several pieces. Martin Hamish studied chemistry. Interesting. Father and I, Kew Gardens. Albert's locker. A picture of Miss White and Albert in front of the University of London.
And they seem to get along.
Specialist articles on shipyards and ship construction. Albert Dunn has a great passion for shipbuilding and the sea. A rejection letter from the British Royal Naval College. Miss White's locker. A draft of the letter that Miss White sent to her parents. Apparently, Miss White is a capable student. These jewels must be worth a small fortune. A vanity purse. It is of high quality. I am curious if the marble that we found will fit this place. Here it is. The marble fragment that we found in the colonial collection room is what they have in common. It is a bust of Montague Dunn. Mr. Hamish, was someone from your family connected with Kew Gardens?
Family? No. I'm the only one with a passion for botany.
I do not think so. This photograph of you and your father at Kew Gardens suggests the opposite.
But you have no right to.
Do tell us more about your father.
He was, indeed, the greatest botanist of his time in the British Empire. He worked together with Montague Dunn until the end of his life. He brought me in at the age of 12.
Did he get on well with Mr. Dunn?
No, I couldn't say that. They expanded Kew Gardens together, that was all. And it was all my father's work, for Dunn always lived the high life.
So Mr. Dunn was not helping your father?
Oh, yes, he provided the financial support. And as far as he was concerned, that fulfilled his role. But the worst of it was, he declared himself as the master of Kew Gardens. Fame meant nothing to my father. So it was easy for Mr. Dunn to take all the credit.
There is a bust of Montague Dunn in the nursery.
A bust? Oh, that old thing. Further proof of that outrageous ego of his.
But why in that room in particular?
Oh, I don't know. It has always been there.
It is strange, because I recovered a fragment of the bust inside the colonial collection room.
Really? Oh, well, so I am mistaken. It ought to have been removed during the cleanup. This room is so small.
Do you know who moved it?
I have no idea. Surely Mr. Dunn requested it. Do you have any more questions like this? Because fragments of rock are not my responsibility.
Evidently. Thank you, Mr. Hamish. We shall continue our investigation. I perceive that you are passionate about the Royal Navy.
Passionate? No, not really. I like ships, that is all.
Are you quite sure? You do not seem to be so interested in plants.
It's difficult, that's all. My future is here. It has never been about anything else.
And yet I know that the Royal Naval College rejected your application.
Ah, you truly are as clever as they say. Yes, that's correct. And in fact, my father was strongly against the idea. He did his best to ruin my plans, although I almost did succeed. But my dreams were shattered, Mr. Holmes.
Thank you, young.